This is the EM2 vertical hit and miss with a flying ball governor. Starting adapter, pull cord, rope starter, and again, a very well packaged engine. This is a nice looking little engine. Very pretty. Flying ball governor operates the exhaust valve up here for hit and miss. A screen on the carburetor. Hall effect sensors over here. Magnet in the flywheel. The flying ball mechanism is driven off of the crankshaft. And the faster the engine runs, the further these balls extend. This cylinder is dished out here a little bit to give extra clearance to these balls. And these balls, when they extend, lift up on this yoke, operates this lever. When this cam mechanism comes around, lifts up the rocker, if these balls are out far enough, that brings this lever under here and holds that exhaust valve open until the engine slows down enough to allow this lever to come out, and then the exhaust valve can close again. And when the exhaust valve is closed, then the engine can fire again. Atmospheric intake valve. When the piston is on the intake stroke, it's traveling downward, draws a slight vacuum on top of the piston. Atmospheric pressure opens this valve, allows air to go in through the carburetor and mix with fuel for combustion. There is no cooling on this engine. It just has these fins in the cylinder and the head. There's no fan or water cooling. There is no throttle or speed control. You adjust the needle valve to where it runs consistently, and the speed is controlled by the flying ball governor. This will run on this tank of fuel for quite a while. When you fill the tank, it's a little hard to get the air out of this line. I just pull this tube off, let it drip onto a paper towel, and push it back on again, and get all that air out of there. Then you can start it straight away. It is human nature to want to reach out and touch something that's spinning or running. And that would be a real bad idea around this gear set. This is real sharp. It will tear the heck out of your finger. Or these things throw oil all over the place. If you're trying to mop up oil while it's running, that can get caught in there. Could do some damage. So be aware of that and keep your eye on people when they're around this and it's running. On this, I put oil in everything. On the springs, on this pivot point, on this disc where the roller goes around, on this pivot point here for this lifter, on this spring, on this yoke, on these joints for the ball, on this rod where this goes up and down, and on the spring, put it on the gears. A little bit on the crankshaft where it exits here, a little bit on the crankshaft on the flywheel side. I used this eyedropper, I had about that much oil in there, and I just dripped it into the crankcase through that breather cap. I have two batteries in here. This one's a dummy. The carburetor, put a mark on here with a Sharpie. The carburetor is just the way it was received. me, this engine is a work of art, a pretty little thing. This will look good sitting on the shelf.